Hey everyone, let's start off today's Up to Speed with a couple of questions. Do you remember Hans's keynote at CES when he talked about drones and their 5G potential? Did you see Rima mention drones again at the quarterly webcast? Did you know that our drone company Skyward serves external customers, but we also use drones internally? Here's the coolest part. Did you know that our network is way ahead of competitors in that regard, thanks to V-teamers who saw an opportunity for innovation and went tenaciously after it? Let's take a look.
Several years ago, I was out in the field with one of my engineers, Chris Schaefer, in Santa Barbara. We were talking about ways we could help categorize issues at the sites. He mentioned that he was a hobbyist drone pilot. So we went out to a general area and he showed me how his drone works and what the possibilities were. So we put together a package. So I invited Abby out to go tour sites with me. Why not? She's my VP. And she said, yes. Abby Knowles is amazing. She's very big into innovation. Took her out to this beautiful area, showing her what the possibilities are in the field. And then we said, you know what? There's an idea we want to throw by you. We're thinking about how drones could help us in the field. Has the potential to save us a lot of money by in-housing, which of course we want to do, and being able to determine what's wrong at a cell site versus trusting and enabling a third party to go out there. We can sometimes see things the vendors can't see. So she saw that potential. Of course, then she came back, she goes, okay, what's your return on investment? What are you going to do this? So we spent a lot of time going back and forth, and eventually it got up to where I presented to Gina and all her direct staff and showed them but the potential of utilizing drones, and they all said, let's do this. We trained the first set of pilots. I have 10 pilots in Northern California in all different areas. Disaster end of it is a big one also for safety for us. It's being used here for fires. This project has gotten so big, there is a group led under Matthew Tuck that is pushing this nationwide.
Verizon definitely thought ahead when they purchased Skyward. Following, I believe, is Hurricane Laura, was that we had some areas with no cell service. We actually had a tower that fell and collapsed. So imagine the ability to take a drone with a tether and an antenna and providing coverage to a town where there is none via a combination of satellite and drone. So you would have this idea of this brand new technology where we can say, hey, we've got this big drone, we attach an antenna to it, we run it down the line, run it through the satellite network, you can stand up the system in less than 2 hours. And of course, with any tool that we push out, what is the first thing our field folks are going to do? They're going to figure out new ways to use it. What if I could do system performance style call testing? And next thing you know, you've got this concept of where does this program head? And now we've got this great vision for where we're going. And it's going to take a little while to get there, but that vision's fantastic.
It looks like a cool toy, but it's a tool. And it's another tool we have in our toolkit in order to help us serve the customers quicker. The industry is just booming. It's just starting. Like we said, with the 4D modeling, with the tethered drones and the flying cell sites, there's so many different directions we can go. It's extremely exciting.
It's great to see innovative ideas helping to maintain our networks and keep V-teamers out of harm's way. Until next time, you're up to speed.